How are you feeling this morning?
Well, you know, I'm not very... I feel a little bit ill, I must say, but no, I'm not going to go on about it. Much. You know what I mean? I don't whinge.
No.
I know.
Okay.
I came here to smell of fish stew, and that didn't help.
Got anything which can help him out, Noel?
Yeah, I'm all over that. I'm going to live in Ricky's house because he's my hero.
Wow.
And this is the greatest moment of my life because I'm sitting between my hero and my absolute nemesis.
Don't start. Don't start on the
he
nemesis.
He married Keira Knightley that I wanted to marry, and I wanted to
feed
you.
That Keira Knightley, the Keira Knightley that he wanted to marry. There was a few, but you married the one that he wanted.
Said that guy.
My hero and my nemesis.
Oh,
I've just got to live in your house in a box under your bed.
Vets are allowed to do medical procedures on humans.
Yeah,
aren't
we were talking about that earlier. Yeah.
What, so what
if you, I'm on speed dial.
I feel like I'm getting gastric flu. Yeah, not that I'm going to win.
Don't worry. In a few minutes, we're going to do mouth-to-mouth resuscitation.
Okay.
It'll be amazing.
Noel said he's only allowed to do stuff if you're on an aeroplane.
No, really? If he gives me volitional consent, like if you were dancing like a chicken and you suddenly died, for example, or asphyxiated, right. I'd be all over that.
Right.
Yeah, straight in. Big biro in the trachea. you're in my hands.
Even if you've got the real equipment, you still use a biro.
Totally.
I always wanted to do this.
I always wanted to take your temperature, Ricky.
I've
always wanted to take the inside of a big biro. Whoa, straight into Ricky's trachea.
This is taking a turn for the worse.
You're feeling a bit dodgy.
It's already a bit weird. It's like a weird dream. I did lose a bit of weight a few years ago when I thought I was going to die after eating 11 sausages in one night. Yeah. Oh. It was Christmas and I lay there like a big snake thinking, like, I won't have to eat for a month. And whenever I do that, I was going to my girlfriend, I'm having a heart attack. And I got a bit fit. I haven't stopped eating too much, but I'm sort of nearly veggie now. I'm pescatarian, so I don't eat meat. And I do work out every day.
What are you doing?
Oh. This is going to be feeble now, though, isn't it?
No!
I do. She got excited when you said courgette. Typical athlete. Oh, courgette. I'm thinking, don't put that in, I'll leave it. I can have a vegetable soup, right, with bread, and at the end, all the vegetables there, like I filtered it out like some sort of...
Like
a whale.
It's
just the vegetables are left. No, but I eat more vegetables now. I work out, I go for a jog, and I work out every day.
Like but, a run.
Yeah, about 40 minutes. That's so I can...
Solid.
Yeah, but that, then I... Load up at night. Yeah. I keep
it's
it even.
It's 8 o'clock feed,
exactly.
Isn't it?
I'm running and I'm going. It's nearly 6 o'clock. Nearly
you know
6 o'clock. Six like... o'clock. The wine's open. That's it. It's all back on.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I burn off 3,000 calories so I can eat 3,000 calories.
Balance.
Look, I'm like an athlete.
Yeah.
He's got an abs video just like yours.
Yeah.
I've seen it.
I've got loads of abs. They're just under that. You can't see them. I keep them covered. I protect them.
Ricky, is there no temptation, though, to have some work done? That's all LA.
What work would I have done?
I don't know.
You don't what need would... anything.
No, they all do it.
See?
my mate, right, I went to see my mate when I was at Glastonbury, and he's had a hair transplant, and he looks amazing. And Simon now is trying to convince... I now want one.
But why would you want a hair transplant?
Because I'm losing my hair.
Yeah, we all are.
I know.
That's what getting old is.
But that's
everything droops, everything falls out.
Ricky, but that's
why... Well, I've got hair that I didn't have everywhere else. I'm like a gorilla from the neck down now. But on the head, it's going. But so what? Look, what would I have done with my teeth? I've had fangs for 50-odd years. Why do I... No.
But that's what I thought, and then I met my mate Tony, and I went... Wow, he looked. I came back and I went, my mate looks amazing. He's just got a full head of hair. He was like,
I've never said that in my life.
I think you should do it.
We've got different relationships with our mates. Yeah.
Tony, you look amazing.
Where did you have your hair done? Oh. Talking to the guy who wrote a book called Flanimals about the weirdest looking creatures in the universe.
And I based it on me in the bath. Yeah.
No, you're talking about Flanimals there. Ricky, you're quite a good artist. Did you draw the pictures for Flanimals? You did.
I did the sketches and then I got a real artist to make him look good. So,
I wanted to ask exactly that. Because you must have one messed up mind. That's all I'm saying.
It started off making my sort of nephew laugh when he was about 8 and I was about 20. And then he grew out of it. And I carried on. So it was just, it's just a little, I suppose, playing with evolution and mucking around with the futility of existence, and it's very sort of dark, and kids love it. They love that sort of horrible, ironic death.
I love stickers everywhere. The reason he's my hero is he does more for animals than almost anybody in the United Kingdom. So fair dues, man. Genuinely, the man does so much for animals.
Well, I disagree with that.
He does.
I do a little bit, and I'm more famous than some people that do a lot, but a lot of people do it absolutely 24/7. They get no reward. They stand outside Tesco's collecting. They actually go there and do it. I do a bit of tweeting and little bits like that, but
well, your cat does a bit of tweeting.
My cat does do a little bit of tweeting. Yeah.
I'm a bit worried about Noel today.
No. I'm just relating to the animalistic instincts around me. It's all good. It's all good. It's my hero. It's my nemesis. I'm in good shape.
What do you think of Brendan?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm neutral.
He's the adjudicator.
Don't get me involved.
He's the adjudicator.
Yeah, I'm the adjudicator.
Ricky's stepping well away from the food. It might be a little bit dangerous. I might just look at it and go, that's lovely.
Have you seen that Netflix documentary?
It's amazing. I never thought that would be an interesting. It's incredible.
The guy. It's the fresh tennis ball.
It's the hardest test in the world. Percentage of people that pass it and how many there are. It's the sommelier test.
It's like a handful every year to get it.
It was incredible. And these people, honestly. It's mad what they can tell. They know what side of the valley the grape is in. What it's mental.
Yeah.
Veggie's cooking away.
All the time, then.
What's that?
You're doing nose exercises all of the time.
Oh, no, I don't do any of that stuff. No. Leave that to the experts.
You're just a perfect man. I hate you all the time.
What am I, chopped liver?
Now there's a little bit of jealousy going on. I like you. Yeah.
Ricky said be nice to him.
Unbelievable, yeah. Thank you.
I'm worried that if someone just tuned in before I said, pretended to get jealous of him, they won't know the backstory.
Oh, no. But they can rewind on the iPod.
They won't be saying things. So they just tune in, I'm going, oh, what am I...
So what does that mean
to anyone who's just tuned in? And then you have to hug me because he doesn't like me anymore.
What it means is that I love you.
Yeah.
I do not love him because he married the lady I love.
I know.
Therefore...
But you hate him. You were going on about how handsome he is, and I was in front of me.
Yeah. I love that I'm the only man in the entire universe to make Ricky Gervais jealous on air. Awesome.
I've always said, if I had the space, I would actually have an apiary. I'd really, really like to
do it. I'd love to have one, yeah.
It'd just be amazing.
How many bees are you talking?
I was going to start with two.
Yeah, two. See if they get on. Like the art.
Yeah, exactly. See how I get took from that.
I think you've got to have the right two with these. I don't think you can just do random two.
I'd go for.
I'm going to start with 10,000.
I think it's actually more like 100,000. I was talking to a beekeeper this week.
And what can they do? How much honey can they make?
It's not a huge quantity. The companies that do it get 20 jars per year.
But what do they do? They've made all that, and that's for storage, isn't it? That's their larder. And we come along and go, cheers, and they go, I've been flying these little wings. Do you know how long that took me? I've been carrying that for a year.
I think, and I'm not an expert on beekeeping itself, but I think they overproduce. I don't think we take
care of
it.
Have some of this. We've got enough.
We're fine for the winter. Yeah.
Do you watch Game of Thrones?
I do. I thought I'd hate it. I thought, Dungeons and Dragons nonsense. Now I'm going, bring on the dragons.
Yeah, it's fantastic.
It's great, isn't it?
You know, Simon doesn't watch it yet, do you?
No, not yet, but
it's good. It teaches you that if you've got a problem with someone, kill them. It's a lovely lesson.
This is Gosnells, and this is made in Peckham, actually quite near to where I live. And this is much less sweet. This has got a nuttiness. It's much lighter in alcohol. So where the last one was about 14%, this is 5.5%.
That's great. I can taste the honey more in that one.
Yeah, so it comes through. You get this sort of crisp nuttiness. It's got a freshness to it. I really like this.
This tastes like a Peckham one.
It's from Peckham, funnily enough.
It's lovely. That's my favourite.
Really, really. 5.5%.
What is going on?
Final one.
I felt ill. It's worrying that this is making me feel better.
I think this is really, really lovely, but I probably wouldn't serve it neat like this. I'd serve it lengthened with soda
it's
and maybe
dangerous
a bit of mint.
Because
and some
it tastes like
lemon.
A soft drink.
Yeah,
it's just too, yeah. That one lets you know, that one reminds you. Yeah.
That is delicious.
And this is stronger as yeah. well. Than that.
All right, let's choose our favourite. Ricky, what's your favourite?
That's the nicest taste, but it feels like I'm not drinking. I think this one.
I think that's the middle one. I think
Peckham.
It's quite
you can't beat Peckham.
You can't beat Peckham.
I'm going Peckham. Cheers to Peckham.